Whenever you want to take the denominator on the other side of the equation, the most important thing to keep in mind is the denominator should be on the entire side. So denominator needs to be on the entire side. That means this is my left hand side and this is my right hand side. So the entire left hand side needs to have the denominator. Does it? No, right? Only 2x has the denominator. So one way of this is to make the denominator the same in the left hand side, right? So can I take an LCM? Yeah.
Yeah.
How do I take an LCM? So the denominator of 2x is 3 and 5 is 1. So I take the LCM of 3 and 1, which will come out to be 3. Do you know how to take the LCM?
I'm not sure. I don't think I remember it, but I don't know how to do like
Do
the
you know how to
method.
solve fractions?
Oh yeah.
Okay. Can you make this fraction into 1?
Oh, so they just all have to be equal.
Yes.
Okay.
How do you make this
Two.
fraction 1?
You
I
just
want you to express this in
times.
a single fraction.
Okay. Times three times two.
So you are timing this by 2 and timing that by 3, right?
Yeah.
Which is basically you making the denominator the same. Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. So basically what you're doing is you're taking the LCM of 2 and 3. So the idea is to make both of these 1. All right? So 2 ones are 2. This will remain 3. 3 ones are 3. This will both of them become 1. Then you can multiply both of these. So that means it's 6. Yes?
Yeah.
Yeah. So for example, you have 2 upon 6 and plus 2 upon 12. How do you take the LCM? Now you will not multiply this by 12 and this by 6. Now you already have a common multiple, so you need to take the LCM because both of them come in the same table also. So I take 6 and 12. I can take the times table of 2. Or I can just take 6, 6 ones are and 6 twos are and 2 ones are, right? Is it making sense?
Yeah.
Okay. So when you do 6 times 2, it's 12. So the denominator of the whole would be 12. That means to make this 12, you multiply both of these by 2. So it becomes 12. This is already 12, so you multiply it by 1. So this becomes 4 plus 2. Make sense?
Yeah.
Does it actually make sense?
Yes.
All right. So if I want to, do you understand? So now we have 3 and 1 as a denominator. So when you take the LCM, it becomes 3, right? Okay.
Yeah.
So I'll make this 3. So 3 times 1 is 3 and 1 times 3 is 3. So this becomes 2x and this becomes 5 threes as 15. So now is the whole denominator on the entire side?
Yeah.
Yeah. So now can I take 3 on the other side?
Yes.
Okay. So 3 is being divided on the left hand side. So it will be
Times three.
what will happen is it will be multiplied on the right hand side, right?
Yeah, multiply three.
Okay, so 11 times 3. Okay, 2x minus 15 is 33. So 2x minus 15, so 15 is being subtracted here, so it will be added here, right? This
Yes.
becomes 8 and this becomes 6. So 2 is being multiplied with x here, so it becomes divided by 68. Do you know how to remember the cancellation we did?
Do you just divide 8 by 2 and then you
This
divide
is
six by
68.
two?
No, you start from the left. So first you divide 6 by 2. So 6 divided by 2 is 3. And 8 divided by
Three.
2 is 4. Understand? You divide, start
Yeah.
from the left. So 34 is your answer. Make sense? We'll keep
Yeah.
practicing. It will start making more sense. I want you to open page 68 of this book.
Okay. 68.
Yes.
Okay.
And I want you to do start with exercise 13, question 1.
Okay.
And when you go to the end to the of this book, just look at the chapter number, which chapter it is. It's chapter 2.5, linear equations, exercise 13. Go towards the end of the book and take a screenshot of the answers of exercise 13. So you have, whenever you complete a question, you can check the answer. The answer should be in front of you. So whenever you're done with the question, you can check. So you
So it's
don't
at
have to
the end
scroll
of the
down.
book.
Yeah, towards the end, you'll have to check that. And I want you to start with question one and go on. We will have to do all of these questions. And whenever you need my help, you will ask me, all right?
Okay.
Okay. First, take a screenshot of the answer so you know. So you don't have to scroll back again and again.
Can I just put the answers in the chat?
Yeah, sure. If that's easy for you, you can do that.
Yeah. Okay.
Are you able to do it, Sasia? Are you able to do the questions? Yeah. Sasi, I'm not able to hear you.
I'm just continuing the questions. I'm on question 18.
All right, you're able to do them? Yeah. Are you able to do them? Sasi, I cannot hear you. Hello. Are you there? Are you able to do the questions?
Yeah, I'm able to do it. I'm on
All right.
question 18.
Okay.
What do I do when there are two X's?
Which question are you talking about? Yeah. Which question are you talking about? Sasia, I cannot hear you. Hello.
Do I put them on one side?
I cannot hear you, Sasia.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, which question are you talking about?
You know when they're like two X's, so like for example,
Okay.
34.
Question 34. So if there are two x's, the same thing happens. So it's 5x and bring the x's on one side. So it's minus x on the right hand side. So if it goes to the left hand side, what will it become?
Plus X plus
Exactly. And 5x plus x is equal to?
6X.
Yes. So this is something we discussed in the last class, right? Addition. So you just
Oh,
add the
okay.
coefficients. Yes.
Okay, thank you.
No worries. All right, Sasia, how much are you done with?